Hey, this is Travis the Tao Templar. Let's take a swing at answering the question, how powerful is Bittensor? To explain, let's review an often overlooked effect of Bitcoin mining. In Bitcoin, miners compete to guess the next random number called a hash. This is what miners produce. How do they do this? Well, over time, mining was first done on CPUs, then GPUs, now ASICs. But really, anything goes. There are no rules. Miners are competing to produce the best possible way to guess hashes. We call this mechanism proof of work. That work is used to secure the blockchain. It is highly valuable work. At the time of this video, winning miners are given $250,000 every 10 minutes for guessing the next hash correctly. In order for miners to get rewards, they have to be really good at guessing hashes. Bitcoin produced an incentive to find the best way to possibly guess these numbers, ASICs. And it will probably continue to improve upon that best way. The result, Bitcoin has found the best way to guess hashes. Now let's look at Bittensor. Bittensor expands the type of work that miners can do. It expands it to anything that can be verified by code. Anything. Instead of miners guessing a number, some are working on training AIs, some are working on trading, some are working on advertising. Each of these tasks is contained in a Bittensor subnet. Let's take a look at the storage subnet. Remember how we observed that Bitcoin produced an incentive to make powerful machines that are very good at guessing hashes. The storage subnet is doing that, but for storage. This means that hundreds of miners are looking for every possible way to provide the cheapest possible storage and as much of it as they can get. How are they doing this? Anything goes. Maybe somebody has a few petabytes of storage laying around from a failed business in India. Maybe some miner pays individuals and companies for their unused space by having them run his unique miner code. Maybe a miner builds an AI to monitor the internet for the cheapest cloud storage and take advantage of promos in order to cut costs. Anything goes, as long as it satisfies the subnet's validator code. In order for miners to get rewards, they have to be really good at providing storage. These miners are competing to find the best possible way to provide storage from anywhere in the world. Remember, Bittensor is permissionless. The storage subnet will produce storage better than any centralized entity can. The result? The best storage, cheapest, most reliable, whatever the validator code asks for, will be provided. Let's take a look at the price prediction subnet. It's attracting teams of traders and AI people to predict the future price of many assets. Remember how we observed in Bitcoin, there's an incentive to make the most powerful machines that are the best at guessing hashes. The price prediction subnet is doing that, but for trading, price prediction. It is producing an incentive to determine future prices better than any single centralized entity. Bittensor expands the type of work that miners can do. It expands it to anything that can be verified by code. Anything. It also does this work better than any centralized entity can. In the same way that Bitcoin solves hashes better than any centralized entity. Why does this work? For Bitcoin, it has produced the best way to guess hashes by aligning market incentives. In Bittensor, it's done the same way, by aligning incentives to take advantage of the immense value in the world's market. So far, we've seen a few dozen subnets or tasks on Bittensor. This number will scale up to over 1,000 this year. Bittensor will fundamentally change how the world works. It will be unimaginably large in scale. Anything that can be verified by code will be done best on Bittensor. One example that jumps to my mind is advertising. Reddit, YouTube, Facebook, TikTok, any social media runs on advertising. What happens when Bittensor does advertising better than everything else? What happens to those platforms? Unimaginably large in scale. How do you get access to this data? Well, you either have to pay a validator or become a validator. How do you become a validator? You have to have a lot of TAO. Why do I use this word unimaginably? Because markets produce unimaginable things. So to answer the question, how powerful is Bittensor? Unimaginably powerful.